My name is Catherine Toth. I'm a professor at Université Laval in Quebec City in Canada, and I'm studying synaptic transmission. And my lab is largely focused on the properties of neurotransmitter release. When it comes to your own advancement, there is always two options that you might have not succeeded because it's your own shortcoming, or because somebody just was not fair. And these two options always exist. I think most of the bias is very subtle, and you cannot really put your finger on it. You can't really prove with a 100% certainty that it occurred. But if you look at the large numbers, if you analyze population data, it's clear, it's there. I grew up in Hungary. I got my PhD in Hungary, and after I graduated, I did a postdoctoral fellowship first in Paris, and another one in the US at the NIH. And then I got my own lab in Canada. And since then, I live in Canada. I think my most important feature is that I'm curious. And I think if you're a scientist and curious, that can take you very far, because that's what you do all day. You solve puzzles. That's your job. I think Canada is doing really well too, in terms of trying to eliminate bias in the system and give equal opportunities to everybody. In Canada, I would say 50% of my colleagues are women. Particularly when it comes to leadership positions, it's still very, very wide. I think there is a long way to go. I think it's important to see changes across different organizational level, including the government. Quotas only means that you are reversing something negative that was happening for a long time. I'm pretty sure that universities would not ever hire somebody who is not qualified. They would leave the job unfilled, because working with somebody who is not qualified for 10, 20, 30 years is a nightmare. Nobody wants to do that. I think the most important things that we do in this period of time is raise awareness against unconscious bias. Studies have shown that just by acknowledging the existence of unconscious bias, committees do better.